Okay, so as you can see, this match I ended up losing. I came into this match at a 16-7. I lost in the ladders match. I think it was a TLC match, actually. Triple threat. I was Bobby Roode, and Braun Strowman won. And then I was Bray Wyatt here, and I managed to pick up a win going to 17-8 by putting Wolfpack Sting through a table. That was pretty cool. That was also a triple threat again with the other Bray Wyatt as well, retro version. And then finally, another win playing as Bret Hart against Sting and the Bulldog. And it was my first win in a ladder or TLC match. And this was just a TLC. The other one was just a ladder. That's really cool as well. This was, at this point, I had realized I wanted to, okay, what's a good way to say it? At this point, I realized I wanted to finish it quickly, because I realized if I try to keep the series going the original way I intended it to go, it wouldn't necessarily be a good idea because, well, there's just too many people in the games. Like, if I wanted to go back and do 2K15, that wouldn't be that big a deal because 2K15's roster is pretty small. But now we're getting to the point, we're at the point now where we have well over 200 people in the game, and I would have literally had to start A to Z as soon as the game dropped, and then keep it going consistently. So I realized I wanted to finish it really quickly, and I thought, okay, well, I'll do 6-man and 8-man matches constantly. And then later on, I realized, oh, hey, you know what's a good way to do that? Royal Rumble. So I felt pretty stupid, but we got there at some point. And the reason I'm showing this whole thing is because this was a really lengthy sequence in the this first chamber match I did, where I was Brock Lesnar, and I ended up having to face Stone Cold at the end. It was pretty lengthy, and it was pretty insane, being completely honest. So that was really cool. I liked it. I managed to reverse the stunner there, but the sliders that I end up that I'm using currently, I mean, God, they were reversing everything. And it was even more difficult when I got to the Rumble matches. I mean, it was pretty insane, to be honest. But I kept just doing what I had to do, and I don't know, I really enjoyed the ending of this chamber match. Again, I thought it was just pretty insane. I mean, I really showed off the fighting spirit in this match. I'll say that. But yeah, the sliders that I was using, go back to that. It's called Beyond Legend. And truly, like, it's a difficult slider set. It really is. And I don't know. That's all I can say is, at this point for this match, Steve was reversing almost everything. I mean, funny enough, he really didn't reverse the Brock signatures. And I got the Kimura a couple of times. Or maybe only once. But he ended up getting out of it because of resiliency. Whether it was one or twice. Once or twice, I mean. Now, I probably, I don't know. Like, I believe I didn't attempt the F5 in this match. So, there's that. But like I said, this match was, I felt it was pretty insane. There are some dull moments, but when it's actually just purely me versus Steve, it's great. So yeah, I got the signature here, the triple power bombs, which, by the way, when has Brock ever done that? I mean, admittedly, when I was first getting into wrestling, it was past the SmackDown 6 era. And, yeah, it was past SmackDown 6 era. Heyman wasn't writing for SmackDown anymore. And, you know, Brock was actually out of the company. So, anything that I know of Brock when he first started is I've gone back and watched it, like, now, in later years. So, yeah. So, did Brock ever do, like, multiple power bombs? Like, slamming you down, picking you straight up, and going to another one. Like, if you know and you're listening to this, like, let me know, please. Because I'm genuinely curious. I am genuinely, absolutely curious. But, either way. Steve, admittedly, like, he kicked my... He beat me up. He beat me up like the club likes to beat up John Cena. That's a PG way of saying what I wanted to say. But, yeah, the slider set, like I said, it's very difficult. And again, if anyone is listening to this and they want to know the sliders I use, I can easily tell you, like show them or something. But either way, this isn't even, well, okay. This isn't, what's a good way to say it? Oh, wait. Oh, no, this is where I reversed it. Okay, I reversed the stunner again there. I wouldn't even say this is my proudest moment in the game. And it's coming up. The moment I would be proud of. You know what, just me knowing what I did, and I just don't want to spoil it here, but knowing what I did later in this match, it reminds me of a 2K16 online match that I had. It was, I think, my fourth online match, and I was Hunter Hearst Helmsley, and I was facing against John Cena, and I actually recorded this, I recorded the match, did commentary later. The commentary is awful, but the video, it is still on the channel, so I could link it if you want to see it. I've also thought about downloading the video from my channel and then doing new commentary over it. Maybe even like showing it to Tyson, because I know he hasn't seen the match before. I think he'd be pretty blown away, because I was absolutely effing insane in that match. So I truly was insane in that match. Sadly, in that match though, I still ended up losing. But I would say I looked good. That's what I'll say. Especially for my fourth online match at the time. And 2K16 servers, they weren't bad, but they definitely weren't great either. Yeah, they weren't bad, but they weren't good either. They were just kind of like mediocre. At times, you could get a pretty good match online, but other times, the servers were downright crappy. I mean, to know how crappy the servers can be, I mean, just go and look at Chris Danker. You know, Dank Ops is 2K King of the Ring either season from 2K16. Because he did a tag team and then a one-on-one first. So, yeah. I just look at that. But we had the double down spot here, where he gave me a pile driver and we're just like, oh, we're both dead. So, there's that. As I've realized, if I just do like a random recording when I'm sitting here just talking to you guys with something playing in the background, I've got this weird problem where like I always have a flash drive near me, and I'll just start like picking up and playing with it. And I don't know why. Especially since, like, just playing with it, you know, I know you can hear that in the mic. So it's not even a good thing. But we're getting the Germans! Yeah! Suplex City! But, I don't know. I want to say I went for the Kimura there, and I reversed the stunner. We were trading reversal sequences there, but that's a pretty cool sequence, you know? Like, I go for the Kimura, he reverses, he goes for the stunner, I reverse, and then I go right into a double leg takedown. That's pretty cool. Then I go right back into the powerbomb. Because it was funny. I don't know why he really wouldn't reverse the signatures, but the finisher reversal, I know for the Beyond Legend sliders I use, the finisher reversal and balancing one, I believe it is. It's pretty high. But, you know, I'll say this. I don't know if I've ever reversed his Luthez press. I really don't know if I have. I don't think so. But going back to that thing with that epic 2K16 online match, I think I've thought about it for a while, and I think it would be really cool. But it's so hard to plan anything around Tyson in the first place. So I don't know if I could. And I don't know. Went for a shooting star press, though. It's like, at that point, I didn't know what to do. It was like, I have to just throw caution to the wind. I have to pull out the biggest move in his arsenal. And was like, I don't know. But it didn't work, as you saw. And then if you ever see in this match, you know, I was like, I'm just like walking around trying to figure out, like, what do I do? Like, that's truly what I was trying to figure out. But then he just caught me out of nowhere, the damn stunner. Here's the moment where I'm pretty insane. I'll say that. Oh, there's a two count. Kick out. No resiliency needed. Like, I didn't use resiliency at all. But then, I don't know how I didn't reverse that one, because I've reversed it again like two or three times earlier in the match. But he caught me with second stunner in a row. Two count. Kick out again. And this man, let me tell you, this man, Stone Cold Steve Austin, went, he had three finishers and nails all three. Goes for the pin, got a one, and a one. I don't know. Sometimes my kickouts are absolutely insane, and then others, I don't know. Because later in this video, when I was doing, like, mass recording session to finish A to Z, there's a match where I was playing Cedric Alexander, and the last, it was an 8-man pin and give up battle royal. I was Cedric Alexander facing off against Chris Jericho. He hit a lion salt, and I just botched the pin on the lion salt and took the L. So, like, I don't know. It's so weird. Sometimes my kickouts are amazing. Other times it's like, I don't know. You have no skill, is how it feels sometimes. Sometimes, I guess. I don't know. It's insane. I'll say that. Let's see. I don't know. Cause, I mean, there's a moment that Tyson and I talk about all the time. We brought it up numerous times on the channel, where we were playing a match in 2K14. He was The Undertaker. I was Jeff Hardy. And in 2K14, I kicked out of three tombstones in that match. So, and then, I mean, during Tournament Tuesdays, I've had some absolutely epic kickouts where we brought that series back. I mean, some of my kickouts are just absolutely amazing. In all honesty, I don't understand why. It's like, I know I have good reflexes. I know I can time things well enough. But I don't know why there's some times where my kickouts are just, like, off the charts. And even saying that, you know, there have been times where Tyson had better kickouts than me. Like, I know later on in the Favorite Wrestlers tournament, like, Tyson's kickouts were way better than mine. I mean, he was kicking out, like, I don't know if it was just, like, the weird, like, adrenaline passion, like, he absolutely wants to take my title from me or whatever it is. But in the Favorite Wrestler tournament, he absolutely could kick out like a freaking beast. And a lot of times, like, I kicked out pretty well. Like, I kicked out well enough, but a lot of the, like, epic kickouts I know I could do for Favorite Wrestler tournament, I just had to use resiliency. And a lot of times, you know, sometimes I used it, sometimes I didn't. I don't like resiliency, but he hit me with a stunner on the outside, and the AI actually ran for the pin there, which is insane. I don't know if I've seen that before either, but that time I didn't kick out, and he beat me with a stunner. So Stone Cold Steve Austin, this match was in Elimination Chamber again with some women, and Billy Kay hit me with her signature, maybe the finisher, I can't remember, no, the signature, and I just botched a kick out as Bianca Belair, and I was gone. Now this face breaker from Candice LeRae, I was Candice, I got a win, so I got 19-10 after this match, and I was able to pin Charlotte Flair, winning another chamber match. And is this the first Rumble coming up? No, this would be, oh, this is Cedric Alexander and Jericho, 19-11, I did lose, he kicks me back down, drops me with a lion salt, and yeah, I just botched the kick out. Sometimes I do, sometimes I do, I don't understand it, but hey. And this match, I just quickly was eliminated in a over-the-top battle royal. Now, this performance, this first Rumble, I absolutely love it. I was playing as Curt Hawkins. because that's who I had to play as because of alphabetical order. And I have probably the run of the century as Kurt Hawkins. Like, it is insane, dude. I had to start off with Rikishi. I want to say I definitely put myself at number one. I want to say I did. I chose everyone's order, but I did it in a random way, and the odds were not in my favor at all. So that just sucks. But we had Dash run up in here, and I absolutely love my run here as Kurt Hawkins, though. I will absolutely say it. Although this, so the way the Rumble settings I was using here, the way I had the Rumble set up was it made it so exhilarating to play the Rumble. Because I had 30-second intervals, everyone at low health. Yeah, everyone at low health, 30-second intervals, and I gave everyone a finisher as soon as they entered the ring. And it was insane. Like, it was so exhilarating. Especially playing as Kurt Hawkins, the lowest in the game overall-wise. Like, it felt really cool to be able to do what I was doing. But honestly, I would recommend doing that. Like, I think that should be a challenge. I know there's a challenge going on in 2K19 right now where, like, defeat the streak from 2K14. That's sort of been brought back for 2K19 with people turning the sliders for the AI all the way up, turning their sliders all the way down, and making The Undertaker 100 overall, and they're calling that 2K19 Defeat the Streak Challenge. And a lot of the bigger creators in the community have been doing that, challenging other creators, and it's absolutely insane. Like, I really like it, though, because it's super cool. And I've even thought about, like, of course, I haven't been challenged to do it, but I've thought about doing the challenge myself. I just think it'd be really cool. But I don't know. I don't know. I probably will, though. I absolutely probably will do it. I just think it'd be really cool. But here's the thing with me. I have so many ideas. And typically when I have an idea, I will try and, like, either type it down somewhere, write it down, like, text it to Tyson, something like that, just so it's like, that way I'll always have the idea, like, it'll never be gone. And I've come up with so many ideas, some that I absolutely want to do, as there goes The Rock, but yeah, something that I absolutely want to do. Like, I've had an idea for a while now to go back to the very first video I uploaded on August 6th, 2014, and recreate it as if, recreate it as if I, were doing it now. And I thought about, I think it'd be super cool, kind of funny, and what makes it even better is, of course, I was wearing an AC/DC shirt in that first video, and it's a different AC/DC shirt, which I probably still have the same AC/DC shirt now. It doesn't fit, though, I guarantee it. That was when I was 14, for Christ's sakes. I mean, I'm 19 right now. Like, I guarantee. Plus, at the time, I hadn't hit my growth spurt yet, so it's like, to be fair, I'm still kind of a tiny dude, but, like, I'm a pretty small guy, in all honesty. But, I mean, I'm shorter than the average height for a guy, absolutely, and I don't know, I'm a pretty small dude, let's be honest here, and at that point I was 14, and I was lucky if I was 5 foot. I was lucky if I was 5 foot. I'm pretty sure I was still 4'11", though. Because I was 4'11 for the longest time. I think I was 4'11 from, like, definitely middle school. I might have been 4'11 from, like, 6th grade all the way up into high school, because I didn't start growing until my family moved back to the South for a year. So, yeah. I'll say that. I will say that. But I thought about recreating the first video again. I just think it'd be, I don't know. I think it'd be really fun. Pretty much simultaneous eliminations there on Daniel Wyatt and Ricochet. Rick O'Shea. Oh, I wonder, do I get The Rock out of here? Like, I know I'm great at button mashing, but I don't know if I'm that good. No, I didn't. I remember at this part now, because I was practically screaming at Ambrose to help me, and of course the AI's like, nah, you good. But, I don't know. Again, I think that'd be fun. And I've been wanting to, like, branch out into, like some sketch comedy and stuff like that for quite some time now. Like, I have a few scripts written, or at the very least started, for some sketches. And I don't know, I think it'd be so much fun. But the problem is, I don't know if I could pull off doing a sketch where I'm playing every character. That's the problem, and I think it'd be like hard enough to, I don't know, try and warrant, or not warrant, but trying to like convince others to be in it. Because I absolutely do not know anyone that would genuinely be willing to be in a comedy sketch. I do not. But I think it'd be really fun, and I definitely think I will do it at some point, whether I had to play every character or not. I absolutely think I will. I just don't know when I'll go about doing that. But I do have, at the time of recording this, I recorded some episodes for a brand new series of a 2K19 universe mode. And this universe mode is a purely casual universe mode. Me sitting, playing the game. I have a very small roster on a show that I love. And I'm just booking what I want to book. And telling stories I want to tell. But not taking it too seriously at the same time. I love it. And before any of you say anything, because I know someone is probably thinking it if you see this video. Listen. Okay, listen. I've already recorded a full month of the first universe. Or not, of this universe. I recorded a full month, the first month of the universe. So, and this series, again, we all know 2K20 will come out. We've heard information, it has been confirmed about it, actually. We know that the voice actor for Buzz in 2K19, The My Career, is more than likely going to reprise his role. He's doing voice acting again, but more than likely he's going to reprise his role. And, yeah. So, we've pretty much all been... It technically hasn't been confirmed, but it's very, very likely that the Buzz's story is continuing. Which is... That's cool. That's really cool. But... Other than that, again, you know, we haven't heard anything. And it's fine. We know the game's going to come out. And we just got to pray that, in this case, no news is good news. And that's what I'll say. We got to pray that Yuke's is putting as much work as they can into it. And they truly want to follow up on what their main goal of 2K19 was, of bringing the fun back to the WWE games. I think they can do it. And I'm also really looking forward to their new game, as I said before. But here, sadly, here is where the epic run of Kurt Hawkins comes to an end. Sami Zayn, he reversed the clothesline, and he has a finish, and bye-bye Kurt Hawkins. Bye, Kurt. Bye. But then we go to another one where I got too aggressive as Dakota Kai, and Maryse threw me over the ropes. EC3 clotheslined me as when I was Dusty Rhodes, but this was an AI simulated rumble, and this was another one, and I took a loss. And I really love A to Z, don't get me wrong, I absolutely do. But again, with an increasing number of people in the game every single year, I love the concept of A to Z. I had genuine fun at the start, but it just got so tiresome and I started getting a little burnt out. And it's just so difficult because like I want to record it, but it's like, ah, but there's still so much to record. Like, what do I do? But earlier today, I also figured out that, you know what, if I need to get through it quickly, you know what's a good way to do that? The Royal Rumble. So I felt really stupid, but we did that, quite a few rumbles. But now I figured out that because of the way I set everything up, it's coming down to a triple threat: King Booker and two Kofi Kingstons. I'm King Booker against the Kofis, and I decided let's end this with a bang, triple threat, WrestleMania Arena, steel cage. Let's just have some fun. I wanted to do a triple threat elimination Hell in a Cell, but you can't turn elimination on with Hell in a Cell in this game, so that sucks. But either way, this intro is already 2.5 minutes. I really don't care. But again, I didn't want to go through A to Z like I did. But again, there's just too many people. We'll start the match. We'll get that loading up. But like I said, just there's too many people. And that's the terrible thing. It's just truly there's too many people in the games to try and warrant doing a series like this. Because if you only do like one-on-one and then tag matches or some stuff like that, you're going through so many matches, and there'll be like freaking there end up being damn near like well over 50 videos in the playlist probably. I'm not about that, I'll be honest. But here is our man, King Bukia! Probably one of the best King of the Rings, in my opinion. But here we go, Mr. Boom Boom Boom, SOS, Kofi Kingston. You know what? I love the New Day, but I miss Kofi's theme. I'm not even listening to it, but I miss the SOS, dude. But there's one Kofi, but that's not it, because we have New Day Kofi. Because don't you dare be sour. Clap for your world famous, however many tag champs they were when 2K19 came out, and feel the power. Because it's a new day, and yes, it is. And I almost timed that pretty well. I give myself credit. So, and I. Some of you may be wondering, like, I definitely am not, like, as energetic as I normally would be. And this is because I'm recording this at almost 9:30 at night. And yeah. And Kofi 2012 was like, I'm gonna escape. Hey man, Kofi 2012. No, you're getting catapulted to the cage. That's what you get. That's what you get, dude. Okay, go over and stop your yourself. While you do that. Ooh. Idiots. Idiots. Oh. Cheesed! I'm the king of this, dude. I'm sorry. I didn't want to do that, but if the Kofis were already gonna try and start escaping quickly, well, gotta be better than that. You gotta be better than that. If you're gonna try and escape as soon as the match starts, If you want to be cheap, Kofi 2012, I'll be cheap too. But, wow, I did not expect that to go down that way. But I've never done a triple threat cage match in this game, so I don't know. But that is the end. What a mediocre way for 2K19 A to Z. But for a series that started to go downhill, admittedly, maybe that's the most fitting way to end. Either way, at the start of this episode, I was coming in at a 20-16 record. If my statistics is correct. If not, you'll know exactly what the record really is. But I should be 21-16. And that's the end of A to Z. We actually finished it. I hope you enjoyed the series. Hope you enjoyed this episode, despite the very mediocre ending. And until next time, I'll see you later. Bye, guys.